Hello, welcome to day one of More Dance with Khalida. While you are signing up, I will talk a bit also for the new people. Welcome, and welcome back for those who were here before. I will talk a bit about what we've been doing up till now, because I received a few questions about it. So in the past weeks, I have been, I've been doing daily lunchtime mini sessions called Let's Dance with Khalida. And I have packaged those, or I have completed that series, and now we will be doing weekly sessions instead. I've renamed the new sessions More Dance for two reasons. Hi, welcome. One, because then I can repeat my outfits. I have a different one every day, so I don't get confused when editing. And two, because I am also making extended videos for each of these sessions. And these are my way of creating something that will last even after this time is over. And also because it's replacing my income for the spring. So if you want to check them out, go to my Gumroad page, www.gumroad.com/Khalida. And you will see all of the classes that I record after the short session. So it's like a full DVD, 1 hour or 45 minutes each. Also, if you check out my online classes, you will see that I've revalued my prices. Over the years, my DVDs have become cheaper and cheaper, because I wanted to make sure that everyone who knows me is able to afford my classes. Now that we are doing the live ones, and I've added a streaming option where you can just pay a small monthly fee to have access to all of my videos, I have rebalanced this. So this is why things have changed a bit, if you are checking it out and you've seen it before. So hi, welcome. Anyway, today we'll be doing something special. This is a snippet of my home workout, one that I've developed over the years. And this is what we will do today, is what I do during the week. So every couple of days, if I feel like my body needs some rebalancing. It's not a workout to kill yourself. Actually, you might not feel it at all while you're doing it, which is nice. It's more like connecting your mind and body, rebalancing your posture, and you get stronger as you do it. On Sundays, Mr. E and I together do a longer workout, which is what will be the extended version of this class. Hi, welcome, welcome. First of all, we will dance a bit, so you also have some dancing going on. And then we will get to work with our equipment. For those of you who haven't seen the post, you will need a yoga mat, maybe two yoga mats or a towel on top to make it more cushioned. A light weight. I have this one. It looks very impressive, but it's only 2 kilos. if you don't have any weights, you can just grab two soup cans or anything. You can build this up into heavier weights, but today we'll just start light and then you can add as you go. Next to that, you will need, I hope you can see it, a shoe, a turnschoen, or a gym shoe, very light and preferably clean, or a yoga block if you don't have something like that. Hi, welcome. Then you need two chairs, same height, and a broomstick. It doesn't have to have a broom, just a stick. This will be for working our back. Okay, so these exercises are meant to be fun. They're not meant to hurt. So use your common sense and see them as a playful way to get more in touch with your body. And you will see amazing results because anything you do that conditions you and helps with your posture will show in anything you do with dance. Okay. Let's begin with a warm-up just with music. Hello, welcome, welcome. A bit louder. We will start. No, don't be scared. Go on the shoulders. I'm just using these tools today because these are items that most anyone has in their home. And you can get creative with them too. Let's roll the shoulders. 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. And change the weight every time. So I'm warming up the feet. by pressing and lifting one heel, warming up the hips by keeping the knees together and twisting, and using the shoulders and ribcage. I'm opening the sides, I'll do two more. One, two, three. And I'm doing a plie for the leg. Last one. One, two, three. One, two, three. Let's do just the hips. Three. One, two, three. Add some arms. Also, I'm wearing minimal clothing today so you can see my legs while I do the exercises. I will also add links to more extensive explanations by other people for those of you who want to experiment with these exercises. One, two, three. And one, two, three. One, two, three. Let's do contraction and open. Back, a little slower, and front. I'm pulling in, pulling away, so my belly button goes behind me, and rounding the upper back, bringing the arms in front. Then I push this chest front and open. So open, elbows lift and close. Elbows lift, chest lift and close. Two more. Make sure you breathe. Let's do arms. If you did Bojenka's class, add a little breathing before you come down. Arm, breathe. Arm, breathe. We're doing one more song. The same one, actually.
Hello. Welcome, welcome.
To my home gym. Let's interlace the fingers and press forward. Again, rounding the back and opening. Round. And just relax. Shoulders come down. Elbows stay up. Exhale. No problem, we're just warming up. And you can check my chat later. Exhale. Even breathing, if you do it with heart, can be a workout. One of the most important ones, actually. Inhale. Exhale. Now bring the arms up. Shoulders up and down. Up and down. Up. Down, up, and down. Hello, welcome, and down. Now we'll reach the normal belly dancer warm up. One, two, and stay with wrists. One, two, and stay with wrists. One, two, and stay with wrists. Now twist and twist. Changing the weight, point the toe. Shoulders, twist. Shoulders, twist. Shoulders, twist. Shoulders, twist. Now shoulders, lift. Shoulders, lift. Shoulders, lift. Shoulders, lift. Figure eight, figure eight, figure eight. To back. Now lift one hip. Squeezing together. Open. Lift the elbows and down. Roll up. Open the chest to the front. Elbows lift, chest to the back, and roll up. Two more of these. Chest front, back, roll, front, back, roll. Shake out.
Alright. Okay, so that should get you started. I advise to have some water nearby and have a sip now, because when I get too excited, I will not stop talking. So have some water, I'll do the same. Yes, and then we'll begin. So in short, this is the brief version of my home workout, the one I and Ernst do together. I also blog these, so we do little variations every week. The beginning is actually the warm-up of the longer workout, and I'll do a simple version of it, which you can build on later on. We will need the light weight, so grab it. And your body. I will also teach you how to pick up things safely. So if you later want to turn this exercise into a deadlift, or if you have to pick up groceries, this will help protect your lower back and strengthen your posture at the same time. What we will do first is called a goblet squat. You might know it. The goblet is the weight that you hold in front. This can also be a kettlebell. In this case, the handles will be here, and you grab the handles, the kettlebell would hang under. So your hands can point up like you would hold a goblet. Now, this already is a posture exercise if you lift your chest and aim your sternum diagonally out while you do this to counteract the weight. You don't want to be rounded. You want to use this weight and push against it so your shoulders will open and you will feel it, you might feel it, under the armpits. So just doing this with good posture is already a great exercise. And your shoulders, you want to have them in one line. So under the ears, not in front, not in back. It's more from the heart. If you lift diagonally, your shoulders will have more freedom and you can rest them while you hold the weight. So that's step one. Step two is how you place the feet. There are options that you can choose from. Most important is that your feet are even. So if one turns out, turn out the other two. If you have one parallel, try to match it with the other and check it before you do, because it might feel different than it looks. So the squat portion, if you hold the weight, mimics how you would squat if you hold someone or something for support. Hello. Yes, you can quote me, no problem. So I'll show you from the side and from the front. By the way, I'm not a super experienced expert in this. This is just my version. So I will place links to professionals showing you this with even better form, I hope. Three things to think about is you pry outwards all of your joint sets, which means I imagine that even though my feet are parallel or slightly turned out, that I turn out my legs without moving them. So this will feel like tension running outwards, and it activates my arch, the arch of my foot. So it's a foot exercise too. So from here, think of turning out without letting your feet release. Yes. Then think of the hips while you turn out going behind the knees. So you're not bending, you're sitting behind you. And if you turn out, this will give you more, or fake turn out, this will give you more strength to do this. So try this out with the goblet, just slightly, just to get a feel for this movement. You want to keep your ears up and your chest up and not go, this is cheating, yes? So you want to go like this, and you might even feel now your abs activating, and that's exactly what you want. Over time, you might be able to go further and further down. But for now, having this feeling of turning out, having this feeling of going behind the knees and lifting the chest, that's what's the goal of this exercise. So we'll do it three times, just like this. I've already done it eight times. No, let's do five. I do it five times, three exercises, five times. And then I do three rounds. Today we'll do five times, just one round, and you can repeat. So goblet, feet, turning out, hips behind you, chest up diagonally. One, and you can play with how far you place the weight. Coming up, squeeze the glutes so it opens the front. Two, keep the elbows together, and squeeze. It's also very good for the back of your legs. Three, smile, and squeeze. Let me read. Yes, you're not standing on your little toes, but without the feet leaving the floor, so the pad of your big toe stays grounded. 4 and 5. You can wiggle here and up. Okay, put the weight to the side. You've survived the goblet squat. We'll move on to the second exercise. For this, you will need the yoga block, the shoe, and the mat. Don't be scared. We're doing just a half hip bridge, which is a great way to mobilize the back and activate the back of your legs, which can sometimes be underworking if the front is very strong, which we dancers often have. So you grab the shoe and you sit down. Easy peasy. The half bridge, for those who might recognize the name, is lying down, rolling up from the tailbone, and then lifting until you are even. So you're not hanging and you're not overarching, but it's a straight line from knee to chest. We'll use the yoga block or shoe to keep the knees together and activate the inner thighs. My feet are in line with my hips, not too far out. You should try to touch them with your hands and try to not turn out the feet, but have them parallel. Okay, 5 times. And you try to roll your spine up. You can press the back of your hand into the floor to open the shoulders. And as you exhale, you roll down slowly. Again, 2. You just easy breathe. It's about lengthening the front more than holding it for long. This should feel nice. Any of these exercises, if you have pain, write to me and I'll think of ways you can modify it. Only do what feels good for your body. I think this is 4. And now 5. You should already feel this. I feel it. And you grab, you shake out. And you do the rolling that we did before for the abs. To sit up. And gently come up. So that's exercise number 2. I hope this is working. I hope you're doing it, or at least trying. Hi, Renata. Third exercise, final one of the warm-up, is the halo. You will need your weight again. By the way, if you pick it up from the floor, you do the same as with the goblet squat, only your feet are a bit more parallel. You keep your chest up and you just lengthen your arms until you pick it up. By turning out and squeezing the lower belly, you will protect your back and keep your posture long when you pick up something heavier. Hi. So you have your weight. If this were a kettlebell, now the bell would be upside down. This would be the bell, this would be the handle. For a normal weight or a soup can, doesn't matter. You're going to bring the feet together, squeeze in the lower belly, then the chest again lifts diagonally out, shoulders relax, neck is long, and you circle it around your head. It's called a halo. So it's like a halo. Do your best to keep your shoulders down and bring it as far as you can safely behind, around and behind. This you can do with a slightly heavier weight. I'm just showing this one because I have it on hand. I do this with 5 kilo or sometimes even heavier, but you start light and see how it feels. I lost count. So you do 5 in each direction. I'll do 1 more just in case to be safe. And I'm squeezing my belly. This is to stabilize. You might feel it all around in your abs if you're really squeezing to not move anything but your upper body. The more you stabilize, the more freedom here, the better for working with props. So that's halo number 3. So we have the goblet squat 5 times, half bridge 5 times, halo 5 in each direction. You repeat that 3 times and then you're good to go. That will be your mini workout. Now 2 more things that will hopefully help you as much as they help me. One is the thing you need the chairs for, and it's an inverted row if you want to Google it. This is what helped me get rid of shoulder pain that I had for 4 years because of scoliosis, because of my pelvis that had gotten out of whack because of a fall on my tailbone 20 years ago. So years and years, I had a spine that became more and more crooked, and I was having pain in my hip and my shoulder, and I did not know what to do. This exercise got rid of it in 4 days. So it's actually magical because it strengthens your back and evens it out. So whatever's going on, it's a safe way. It doesn't hurt. It's a safe way to just help your body become stronger in the muscles that we often underuse. So try it out. I hope it works for you as well as it does for me. You only need to do this 5 times. And then you rest. You don't have to make yourself tired. Just activate your brain and body and let it process. And then you do it again the day after and the day after if you want. So let's do it. For this, for safety, make sure your chairs are sturdy and put them at the distance of shoulders plus 1 or 2 fists. If you put them too wide, they might cave in. Your broomstick should be in the middle, so not back and not front, because it might roll. I'm placing myself a bit behind the broomstick, and my hands are like this with the palms in front. Okay. Like this. And you can scoot the hips forward slightly. The easier variation is with the feet bent like this, so you can use them to lighten the load. We're going to pull ourselves up. Okay, let's come down first. You want to have full range, so you hang and check for stability. You pull yourself up with the elbows parallel, and you come down. The slower you do this, the more effective it will be. Let's do 5, 2. Now I'm doing 3 like this, and 2 more difficult if you want. 3. Even if you don't feel it, it's a magical exercise because of the after effects. More difficult, if you want, is to lengthen the legs, squeeze the glutes, and lift the chest. From here, you pull your full body, but be careful with the chairs. You can also do it with a ballet bar, but I wanted to do the ghetto version, the one that I did. So that's it. That's the inverted row. You have done it.
Repeat it tomorrow, and then the day, then 2 days later, do it again.
This will help you with your posture to keep it relaxed, which means your arms will be more free to move.
Okay, final exercise, and this one is a fun challenge, one that I had to practice. You will need the shoe or the yoga block. Yes, the ghetto version. This one is called the Turkish get-up. It's not related to the Turkish drop. Maybe it is. It's a way to get up while you mobilize and at the same time strengthen and even out your joints. You can imagine this as a way to safely get up from lying on your back. It has different stages, which I will demonstrate. And when you are standing, so you did the Turkish get up, you reverse the exercise and come down using the same positions. The challenge would be, after you've learned the steps, to make a fist, like we practiced in one of the first classes, and make a flat surface here, and you balance. Let me grab my shoe. You balance your shoe on top. Yes, under the kitchen table also would work. But I like to have something that I can put my hands around. So you balance on your fist. This is more difficult with a yoga block, which is why I prefer this. Yes. So the exercise first. I have 6 minutes. I can do this.
So you start by lying on your back. I will film it from a different angle if you cannot see. And opening the legs slightly. The arms also slightly. You put one leg up. The same arm goes straight, a fist to the ceiling. Then you want to roll onto this elbow, which is why I have the mat, by pressing with this foot and looking up, your fist straight up. This already is a challenge. So try this from here by pressing your foot into the floor. You can look diagonally, but keep your fist to the floor. Step 1. Step 2 would be from here to
Exhale and bring your weight up so you sit on both sit bones. So you settle, your shoe is still balanced. Now the most tricky part, you can adapt your foot and scoot it out a bit. This leg will go under by lifting the hips. This is why we did the hip bridge, half hip bridge. From here, this is a side plank hip bridge variation. Your shoe is still in the air. Yes, belly button in. Now to get from here to sitting, you can windshield wipe this back leg like this, and you come up into a one knee. For this position, try to drop this hip so it's one line and lift the front of the pelvis so it's a posture exercise. Your shoe is still balanced. Now, by shifting the weight to the front foot and the back foot, so I'm placing my toes under, evenly, I come up and then I gently place my foot parallel. So they're not turned out, I try to keep it parallel. My shoe is still on my fist. Yes. If you make it to here, you turn and you've completed the Turkish get up. To get down, same thing in reverse. Feet parallel. I call this the Pharaoh stance because in the hieroglyphs they all have these feet. From there, gently come down. Try to have a straight line and the hips square. I'm looking in front of me for balance. I windshield wipe the foot in so I can gently come down, balancing with my hand here into my half side plank. Then I press onto this foot. I hope you're trying it. And I gently sit down, balancing on both sit bones, chest is up. From here, I will glide to my elbow and I will come down gently. I grab my shoe and you're down. So try this in stages. First the roll, then the sitting, then the half bridge sweep, the challenging one, then to sitting on one knee, then coming up, then facing forward. I will use my shoe to hopefully demonstrate the balancing. And if you've done this, you have a magical exercise which will help you reset everything. Try it out, it's worth it, I promise. And if you get into trouble, if you're not sure, just send me a video of what you're doing and I can help you. Yes? So grab your something to balance and let's try it. Let's try it. No guarantees. It's about the challenging your brain and body. This will make you better in balance, in coordination and strength and mobility at the same time. All right, so coming down, I'll try the other foot. Feet a bit out, so on the corners of the mat, arms will be slightly widened, palms up. So my other leg is not parallel, but a bit diagonal. Make a fist, thumb is out. Balance, try to not have a shoe print on your face after this. And then you roll. I'm a bit too close to my chair construction. Cats, if you have pets, they will love this if you are on the floor. So from here, same leg as arm, up. Try to roll your shoulder down so it's already packed and connected to your back. I look diagonally and I roll gently onto my elbow while pressing with my foot. And you exhale. Try to keep your arm as straight as you can. From here, I press onto my hand and I move my foot so I sit on both sit bones. Here, I will move this foot so I can lift my hips a little, not all the way up, and stick my leg under into a side plank. From here, I'm still looking up until I am parallel, then I look forward, straight to the front. Hips are same level, front of the hips up. I put the toes under and exhale, split stance. This already is good for exercise. I'll show you like this. If you square the hips and pull up the front, you'll feel a nice stretch here, which is good for shimmies. From there, parallel stance, and you can get down. I hope you're still with me. From there, you get down, same leg in front as the arm that's up. You look straight ahead, gently, gently down, no bonk. You windshield wipe the feet, and you put the toes down. You gently sit. Grab the floor, side plank, lift the hip, and sit. Both sit bones, posture exercise, lower belly in, roll to the elbow, slide down, both shoulders connect, and you did it. And you did it.
Okay, let's finish up this slightly extended session with a song and adding shimmies, arms, chest, lower belly, because you should feel your whole body after this. So let's do this. I hope this made sense. It seems complex until it clicks, and then you have it for the rest of your life. So I recommend really practicing this. It is a golden exercise. Okay, let's shimmy. You might feel your hips better now. Arms up. Celebrate what you just did. Let your mind and body process. And give it a rest. Don't do this tomorrow. Give it one day of rest and do it the day after. So ignore what I said before. Do it every second day just to get used to it. Arms, both arms, and breathe. Okay, let's shimmy in split stance. So like we did, weight front, and now lengthen this leg, both legs shimmy. Chest out. And waterfall. If this movement trips you up, it's class 3 from Let's Dance, the previous series. You will find it in the group. Both legs shimmy. Chest out. And reverse. Let's jewel. In. Jewel vertical to the front. And to the back. With a shimmy. Jewel. Jewel. Shimmy. Arm. Arm and circle, shoulders, nice, and that's it. You have now hopefully gained some insight into what I do to stay fit. If I have a photo shoot coming up, I do a mix of this and the extended workout just a couple of times a week, and it helps me to define my body more. So, but mostly these exercises are for me a way to feel younger and to be able to keep doing what I do without any pain and without feeling restricted. On top of this, I recommend also doing flexibility work. So this exercise set plus stretching will help you move more smoothly and will help you feel just more energized and more free and more loose. So thank you very, very much for joining this class. The next one will be on Wednesday, also same time, 12:30. And if you have topic wishes, I want to keep doing this for at least as long as we are stuck at home. So just simply put it in the comments and I will read them later and we will make a new series. Thank you very much for joining. See you. Bye-bye.